Darah-Dandoa forces have claimed victory after U.S. troops have retreated from two engagements near the... released an official statement on their strategic withdrawal from the small skirmishes on... of Springfield, Texas, after the non-voluntary smallpox vaccination. Health workers could not divulge...
They should tell us what they know. It's our lives.
Dramatic footage from Television Free Indonesia showing Darah-Dandoa leader Suwadi Sadono apparently engaged in battle. It remains...
There's too much noise on the line. I'm not sure we'll be able to connect you to Sarah before we land.
We'll have the agency file on Pandora tomorrow, ready by the time you touch down. You're right. It's Sadono's insurance policy. If he misses a phone call, the virus gets released. We're vaccinating Springfield, Texas. But until we know how many other pox boxes there are, and where, Sadono is a glaring tripwire. We're going to have to tiptoe around him.
Did Grim write these smallpox flash notes?
Yeah, she's a poet in her own way. But she makes an interesting point. We slip up in Indonesia, and those images could be illustrations of anywhere in America.
I'm sorry, Fisher. I can't get Sarah on the line.
I don't know what I'd say to her anyway.
Refinery, Kundang, Indonesia, April 12th, 2006, 15:12 hours. Trail intercepts Sadono's communications. Pandora Tomorrow is the proof reads for Sadono's insurance policy against US attack. He makes daily secure phone calls to undisclosed US locations, delaying release of the smallpox virus one more day. If he is killed or detained, the virus will be released within 24 hours. Intercept Sadono's Pandora Tomorrow call in order to locate the virus. Greetings, fellow things. Welcome back to Tom Clancy's Splinter and Pandora Tomorrow. Well, this mission is pretty straightforward. It's a long mission, as far as I remember. It's a little bit of a long mission, but I do believe this is... we are slowly creeping towards the end of the game. It would be this mission, then a submarine mission, and then another mission, then there's something in the jungles. And we should be good to go after that. But yeah, let's see how we fare with this mission. There's also the LX mission, but I think we're getting a bit too ahead of ourselves here. To recapitulate on the story thus far, terrorists attack the US Embassy in Delhi. Fisher finds out that they have some terrorist plans of theirs. It takes them to Paris to look for a person called the Modified Penguin. Turns out that guy was an ex-CIA agent who has now turned and is helping the terrorists. That lead takes them to Jerusalem, and where they find out that it was, in fact, a smallpox virus designed to become an insurance policy for Sadono that we more or less just realized in this video introduction right before this briefing. The game is pretty simple. It's pretty straightforward right now. We just need to get the smallpox vaccination, neutralize that threat so that... appropriate forces can handle the terrorist threat appropriately. And when I say appropriate forces, I mean probably the Delta Force. So yeah, right now the playing field is uneven. We can't exactly target Sadono without risking, deleting various places across the, various landmarks across the United States. But if we can neutralize this threat, then it will be a pretty open and shut case for the Delta Force. Go and eliminate Sadono, get out. Or if not, maybe just shut down his operations. That works in pretty much the same way as well. So, yeah, without further ado, let's see what this level is about. Pretty sure we're going to see Deadly Shepard here.
This is going to be a complicated mission, Fisher. We're running it in cooperation with Displaced International, so your old friend Douglas Shetland will be local.
Good. I can work with Shetland. What's Shetland doing here?
A ghost army operation. He'll give you the brief.
All right, this is... I don't think I've seen Sam in this game much. I think this is the only time that we get to see Sam in this game, at least in the original trilogy. I mean, I think you can make something close to it in the latter games, especially Blacklist, but as far as the original trilogy is concerned, this is pretty much the only time that we get to see Sam in this game. And that would be our dear friend Shetland.
Howdy, Shetland.
Fisher. My God, old man, you keep turning up in unexpected places. I'd hope the next place we met would have been stateside. I'd like to buy you a beer, see how Sarah's doing.
Let's leave home where it is. What's this ghost army business?
Psyops, a distraction.
What's my part?
Your handler should have your objectives. For my part, Sadono's plane in the yard near the village needs to be sabotaged.
Since I was going to be in the neighborhood anyway.
Much appreciated. I've got a dozen displaced snipers around the camp. You won't see them, but you better believe they're there.
It's good to see you again, Shetland. Once we're back home, we'll get that beer.
Glad to hear it. We need to have a talk about some work I might have for you.
I've already got an employer, and they hear everything we say.
Good. They should know a man with your skills deserves more money and autonomy. A man should fight any war but his own. Especially in the America we've got today.
Take a good look at this face. He's what I would call a staunch believer in this country. And he doesn't want to see it go to waste. Is what I would like to say, but yeah. We'll get to that when we take yours here. So we have here a field of wheat. It looks like cannabis. Yes, it is cannabis. Yeah, there's like a literal field of wheat right here. And all we need to do is basically just trudge on ahead in that direction. I think there's also a minefield up ahead. I don't think the soldier ever comes here, but let him trip on the ladder, so that's the thing. There are some bottles here hinting at the fact that we might need some distractions up ahead. Oh, I see. Now, here's the part where I would like to figure out whether the distraction is actually needed or not. By the way, the leaves look spectacular. Well, it seems that the distraction is not that necessary. I mean, Fisher is hardly seen, so... I think we could have gone from the other side of the truck as well, but I'm not entirely certain about that. Okay, so I've been struggling with this section for a bit now.
So go and get another bottle. Hell no, I don't want to get blown up. And why are my chances any better than yours?
Because you helped lay the traps.
Not all of them. Besides, they're easy to spot. Just look for the trip wires.
I can't look for trip wires. I'm drunk.
I drank as much as you did.
So that should make you braver. Remember, you need to fix the broken mine.
Yeah, I'll do it now.
Be careful, man.
So I guess I'll just wait a little more patiently. Yeah, that seems to have worked. Not for him, that did not work out for him, apparently. Unfortunate, but if you were gonna play the traps, you... About where you buried them, basically. So I don't know whether I'm supposed to just wait here until this guy, you know, moves, or whether I can move as well, but I'm just gonna play this cautiously and not rush through it. I think that guy is like resetting the trap right now. Ah yeah, I think so. Now I just gotta wait until that guy turns around. And we should be good enough. Okay. I think it's much easier to spot these traps. With the night vision mode. Enabled? Yeah, I don't know which one is disabled, to be honest. I can see two here. Okay. I see that one. I just hope that I didn't get spotted by that guy. What sucks about this mode is that I can hardly tell. Okay. Miraculously, nothing happened. But miraculously, there's another guy in front of me. And I need to be careful about two people now. Now, I think I'm hidden, but I'm not certain at this point. Yeah, I think I am. And none of these people can see me, so that's good. That guy's headed here. I can't move right as of right now, but I could probably shield him afterwards. Here's to hoping, unless and until the patrol patterns sort of sync up like they're supposed to. Why'd you stop, sir? Why did you stop? Don't stop like that. Don't scare me. I think I should be safe here. Again, difficult to be sure. I've not seen any more traps in front of me except for one over there. But it seems like a dark enough crevice to where, you know, that guy should not be able to see me. These seem to be chip fires for the most part, though. Am I gonna have to disable this? Maybe. I think this is a nice spot for me, a nice spot where I can hide. I don't think I would like to go in the light there under any circumstances. I don't think there is anything over there anywhere. I think this is the way to proceed forward for us anyway. Let me just go ahead and make a save here. Yeah, like some sections of this game have always been tricky, and just checking that I do not think there are any more traps up ahead. I think the next section was pretty straightforward. Ah, yes, the airplane hangar. Basically, we gotta navigate through.
You should be close to Sadono's plane, Fisher.
Really?
So yeah, as far as I recall, doing this section peacefully was quite a challenge.
Is the plane ready to go?
No, we're still waiting for the product and the pilot.
They're so slow today. We've been guarding this plane forever now.
Sadono is checking the place.
Go and double check the back of the plane. That'll keep you occupied.
Why? I just spent the last 4 hours verifying it.
Go!
Something's moving.
So, I had a choice to make there, and I chose to just go ahead and turn the lights off.
Who is that? Show yourself!
Maybe that will aid us in putting the bomb on the screen. But that guy did say to go and check the tailor.
We're imagining things.
Yeah, I mean, you did imagine the lights just spontaneously going out as well, that is true. I wouldn't put the blame on you for that. So yeah, a distraction that pretty much worked in our favor. Now where do we need to go now? Where do we need to...
Good work, Fisher.
I wonder if I need to... Yeah, this one guy that comes in here to do his business. Pretty sure there were no other guys, but I'm just gonna go all the way in here and save. Just in case there were.
Why? Are you saying you don't support Sadono?
No! No! I've got an allergic reaction to machetes, which makes me a firm Dara Dandoa supporter.
I'm glad to have Sadono here. Suddenly feels like we have a cause beyond money. Somebody to follow.
Yeah, but so many executions.
It's only a process of refinement. Productivity is up, security is tighter. Just keep yourself useful and patriotic so you don't end up on the chopping block.
So, as far as I remember in this section, what I needed to do was... It took you a while to get on those boxes, Fisher. Yeah, so basically what we wanted to do was cause a distraction, this, you know, basically boot, as far as I remember, so that we can actually get that, you know, gate up, power wire gate up. Now, what if the sand is, why can't Fisher just crawl underneath it? I mean, he probably should be able to, right? And I think he should be able to just jump on top of it as well. Let me go ahead and try that. Yeah, that did not work out as planned. I'll just let this guy down here, and then... I'm still wondering how I'm gonna be able to achieve this. Maybe the ring if I want, perhaps that could be the solution.
Is somebody shooting?
Yeah, so what I need to do next is just go inside that barrier thingy, and, well... Maybe I can try something.
Who is that? Show
Show yourself!
Yeah, I just want both of these guards to be going that way, so that I can sneak over to this side. Good save. Because I'm going to attempt to sneak over here instead. Because this is a section with a dog. And, yeah. I just realized the brightness of this game is so low I can hardly tell what's where. And I suppose that's good. I suppose that is as things should be. And the thing about dogs is, as long as they're sticking to... like the corners, it doesn't really matter if the dog can see you or smell you or whatever. It won't be able to bother you anyway.
What is that?
Does not matter if that guy can't see you. Like, it doesn't matter even if that guy sees you. And the dogs in this level don't really follow you either. So you're pretty much fine either way. There are some traps in here apparently that we need to be careful of. Good thing I didn't step on it. Otherwise I would have been done. I'll just go ahead and disable it. Our objective is supposed to be a... well, where we want to go rather, is supposed to be this thing in the... in the middle, oh yeah, that right there, that thing. That's where we're supposed to go. And hopefully that guy doesn't really come any closer. He does. Nice. So basically, yeah, we just need to cut in through one of these sets and make it all the way over there. I'm assuming this tent would be the best route, because I don't think I see anybody in there. Actually see me. That's strange. How do you see me through the tent?
We're imagining things.
Good, good, good. You finally see sense. Very good. Not gonna shoot that line out as well, but yeah, pretty much I just wanted to.
We're imagining things.
Good, 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 good. You realize that you're imagining things, that's very good. There's no way apart from, you know, just having to take this guy out anyway. I like the way the music picked up though, and this will take us to the next stage.
Security stage increased. Stage 1.
I'm inside the camp.
The core of your mission is Sadono. He's on site. We need you to locate and trail him. But again, don't let him spot you.
Pandora Tomorrow?
That's the idea. We haven't been able to trace his daily insurance call remotely, so we're gonna need you to get in there with a tap. Fifth Freedom with Sadono Militia. But don't get spotted before tapping the phone. Updates on your OPSAT.
Roger that. And I do believe that it's a simple trailing mission. And that's Sadono right there.
Good afternoon.
It is, sir. Things are going good.
We have quite a few avenues that we can pursue here, just need to be a little patient and not rush through it. I do believe we can also like just go in through the bottom of that house right there. I'm not certain whether this guy is patrolling the yard or not, but I'm just gonna use this opportunity to sneak past them, these people. I have no idea how those people, that one guard inside, you know, the building did not spot me, but he apparently did not. That's on him. Anyway, We can move along at a slightly faster rate. Lots of shadows, plenty of shadows for us to explore.
Any complications?
Of course. Sadono changes the passcode for entry twice daily. He doesn't write it down. He gives it verbally to his three top lieutenants on site.
So I grab one and make him talk.
No. We need to stay discreet. We can't afford to have Sadono panic and skip a call. Use the sticky cam to overhear those conversations. Details on your OPSAT.
You can use your sticky cam to overhear the code.
How does it go?
Real good. We're ahead of schedule.
On?
Product.
We'll meet tonight. I want to review our distribution arms.
I'll be there.
Good. The code for the big house today is 1492. Can you remember that?
1492. I got it.
Good. There's a colonial home overlooking the compound at the end of the village. That's where Sadono makes his Pandora Tomorrow phone call. That's where you'll need to be to tap it. Trail him, so you'll be sure to be there on time.
Unless there's some other way that I'm missing, that is the way I'm just... Quite strange that this guy doesn't want to get up there, though. I mean, we can take this guy out as well, but... Diversion cam... Is there anything there that will help us get up there? Those pipes, perhaps?
I hear somebody!
Nope. Finally. I don't think we need to go down, but then again, I suppose we do need to go down. That is the only way forward. That's like an object for a distraction. We do not need to pick that up.
I'm getting paranoid.
What about? Hearing things that aren't there, seeing things that you should not be seeing. You mean that way? I think that is the way in. Yes, that was. And this is supposed to be the way out, I suppose. Again, I'm not certain. But at any rate, I do not suppose that would be a wise idea just to go out through the door like that. So we'll go out through here instead, in style. There's the guy right there who was basically guarding the base. Good thing I saved here. Should I? Lucky me. I almost bumped into Sadono right there. And I do not think this was the correct way, either. I think we were supposed to rather just... Yeah, go through a gap in here, yes. Oh well, too late for that now. I think this is where we get an opportunity to hear Sadono talk about his Good, if we haven't heard it already. Let me try something here. Yeah, so I'm able to get on top of the boxes after destroying these lights here. But what I'm not able to do is... well, get past these guys with that puny amount of distraction that I'm managing to obtain. I guess you have. And how do I get up? I think we could use this rail right here to make things, you know, essentially meet our ends. And yeah, I suppose this is how we go up top. I was trying to find the boxes, but yeah, I suppose this is the right way. Just a minute there. Sorry about that, there was this knocking sound in my right ear, which I was uncertain whether that was a part of the game or something that was happening in real life. And I mean, the headphones that I'm using, Audio Technica ATH-M50X, I didn't need to take the full name like that, but I did anyway. But yeah, these headphones are surreal. And when I say surreal, I mean they're surreal in their ability to represent audio accurately as far as especially the sound stage is concerned. So yeah, it's oftentimes that I get confused whether some audio sources are real or, you know, something that is a part of the media that I'm consuming. So, it happens to me quite often, is basically what I'm trying to say.
I'm concerned about security.
We're in good shape, though I wish you would stay out of plain sight.
Don't worry, I'm fine. Bullets can't find. Any risk is worth the confidence my presence gives our men. And the anxiety it causes the West. Have you seen the news reports lately?
I don't watch TV.
Let's go ahead and take this light out as well. Should make things marginally easier for me. And I don't think I'm supposed to go down here because it's all lit up, this area. No, what I think I'm supposed to do is go down the other way instead. Like I said, it has been a while since I last played this game. I'm not a huge fan of Pandora Tomorrow, although this mission is one of the few missions that I actually do like from this franchise. Still not a particularly big fan of this game. I think that is a sound from the game itself, because... a knocking sound. Let me just go and observe these people's pattern for a while here. Their patrol pattern, and while I'm at it, let me just go and save. I'll just stay perch the top here like Batman and wait for that guy to... basically... stop moving. So yeah, at least I managed to determine that the noise that I thought was coming from elsewhere was in fact coming from my earphones. Knowing some of the pattern, I see. Should be okay for us to proceed at this point. Or so I would suppose. Should be okay for us to stay in this shadow right here. Just behind this guy. Although how I get past him is something that I've not figured out yet. Maybe like this. This guy doesn't seem to mind me being behind him anyway, so... Yeah, so that knocking sound that you guys can hear, yeah, that's pretty much what was sort of distracting me all this while. I thought it was perhaps something in real life. Turns out it's just part of the game. Oh yeah, I think this is the third part of the mission, and...
Got a heads up for you from Grim.
We're going to be losing touch in a second. There must be copper coils or some kind of grid ahead of you. The refinery proper is a dead signal hole. Good luck with your airplane, pilot.
We're going to be out of contact as long as you're underground.
I'll try not to get too lonely.
Yeah, section number 3, and slightly annoying. Especially when it comes to figuring out where to go. I mean, that guy, Fisher just dropped with a pretty heavy thud there. I'm curious about how that guy didn't like notice it. Let me try making a move. Swatch roll time, is it? I do believe so. Swatch rolls for the win. Yeah, we need to make it to the other end of that place without alerting anybody to our presence. Let me just go and use an optic cable on this door, seems clear. Oh yeah, this part, right. Now the thing about this part is... as far as I remember, if I recall correctly, we're just supposed to turn the light off and just proceed down the middle. Because that's the only place where there will be no guards patrolling. Because I think there are two guards standing at the corners right there. And this is like a cocaine plant. Which is quite strange because I didn't see any cocoa plants around. Maybe there were, I've never seen a cocoa plant in real life either. So there probably were cocoa plants around. And yeah, we just need to proceed down the center. And there should be a door on the right if I remember correctly. Yes, there is. And yeah, that's like a pretty simple solution to this part.
Who turned the lights out?
That guy went all the way there to investigate who turned the lights out, but...
Is the plane alright? Go. Don't waste more time.
Did not actually bother to check who turned the lights off. Yeah, so right now we've got two options. We can either... turn this thing off, which will help us infiltrate this base. Or so I hope. Unfortunately for us, that guy over in the corner, he does not move from his position. So we just have to move this, make do with what we have.
The light broke!
What was the keypad code again? Excuse me. 1492, right. 1492. What? I thought that was the keypad code. Code for the villa. Right. 1492. I guess I need to grab this guy then.
Eternal dirt.
Thank God you found me. Ignominious getaway.
I'm short on time. What do I need to know?
This name, Stanley Nakaryakov, Golden Triangle affiliated. He lives in the Lei Yuman district of Hong Kong. But don't broadcast it electronically. This part of the world is made of ears.
My encryption is solid.
I wouldn't count on it. There's more to Japan's ISDF than they're letting on.
How do you know?
I've seen two other, CIA resources disappear.
So how do you know it's the ISDF?
Money knows everything. The name is Stanley Nakaryakov. Got it?
Yeah. Just one piece of advice. Don't take your plane. What are you doing down here?
It's the only secure place in the camp. They can't hear me down here.
The ISDF can't hear you?
No, the people who are using it. I can't talk.
And that's that. So I think right now this keypad. Maybe we need to stop this.
Please,
person.
Go away.
Yeah, this guy's gonna spirit tight. Let's 1492. Let us try that again. Maybe now the door will open. Access denied. Oh, 0623. I wonder how we get access to that kind of information. Anyway, that's what we were here for. And
I think I see something.
There you go.
What?
A diversion can, yes. All the way over there.
Welcome back to Fresh Air.
Do you have the name?
Fisher. Go tap that phone. We'll talk about the names later.
I'm gonna kill somebody if they don't stop shooting soon. That noise is gonna break my ears. Seriously, they're ringing.
Nag, nag, nag.
I'm a musician. My ears are very sensitive. Why did they always give us this patrol?
What about me? I've got to listen to the constant gunfire and your constant complaining.
I feel like somebody's kicking me in the head.
Now there's an idea.
I think we're supposed to go up top instead of just stay out here. I'm not sure, of course. I think that is the case. Could also be not the case. But at any rate, the trailing continues. There's no, you know, pause as far as the trailing is concerned. We're still trailing Sadono. Saudi Sadono, that is. And let's see how this goes. I think we've been offered the flares because of this automated turret transfer. Yes, we will. I do not recall if this mission has any gunfight sections here or not. Oh no. I first actually wanted to opticate it by the inside. Before I did any of this, but okay. Maybe this works, I suppose. Why did that guy look up? Why is that guy looking up? That guy's looking up all the time. Who the hell looks up at the ceiling inside of a closed room? Can you please be a little more normal and just resume your business, whatever it is, but Sam passed by peacefully. Okay, that guy did not spot me, so that is, I suppose, a good sign. about that guy over there. It's a different story. So here's a nifty little detail. In Pandora, sorry, in Chaos Theory, that guy's got some skill, I'm not aware. Yeah, so in Chaos Theory, if an enemy can see your shadow, that is usually enough to alert them to your presence. So when my shadow passed over this guy's face, that should have been enough sign for him to actually realize that something is wrong. Something is amiss, rather. But yeah, then again, to his benefit, I do suppose that...
Be careful. The access to the house isn't as easy as it seems. You should wait for darkness.
And darkness comes down super soon in this game. I mean, just as we wait, look at this tree growing out of nowhere. That tree is gonna, you know, pretty much just meet the doorway in a while. Give us like complete darkness. Pretty odd set piece, but it is what it is. Now, what I need to figure out, the next bit that I need to figure out, is how to get over into the house. I'm pretty sure it's not going to be through the front yard, because that does not seem to work, but... Like, this automated turret here that is protecting the house, so I can't exactly go through the front gate, but... I wonder if there's any other means for me to get inside the house. I don't even have the... Oh, okay. I need to get into this room right here. I doubt the window's open, so we're gonna have to time it so then that guy is leaving. This villain-looking guy is leaving. And that would be our cue to enter. Sure, you can see me right here, sir. Yeah, so we basically need to be careful of this spotlight here. I'm just gonna go over in this direction because, well, spotlight is moving. This is bothering me than on the other side.
I hear you, come out!
This should clear a path for me to go. Here's to hoping that
Code is 0526 5173 337 3889. Pandora tomorrow. Good. Until tomorrow.
That guy already made his Pandora tomorrow call, but we need to essentially... Yeah, now what do I do? There's like a turret there, so I guess the only way we can do is forward. I suppose we just need to time it when there's nobody who's looking in that direction. I'm surprised that I haven't been shot by the turret yet. As far as he's concerned, we are in the darkness, but Okay, so this guy doesn't indeed turn around. Probably should have been on the other side, but then again, that turret is far closer. I'll just stick here until that guy comes back. I'm still surprised that this turret is not able to see me. I mean, typically, turrets should be able to see you at this range. I wonder if they're not set up properly. That's the only logical explanation as to why they aren't functioning yet. Whew, darkness. My favorite. Okay, our cameras here. I suppose it's best to just stick to... Oh, I see.
It's me. Today's code is 0526 5173 337 3889. Pandora Tomorrow.
How many times are you gonna provide that code throughout the day?
It's me. Today's code is 0526 5173 337 3889. Pandora Tomorrow. Good. It's me. Today's code is 0526 5173 337 3889. Pandora Tomorrow. Good.
They're keeping your phone, son. Okay, on the desk. Alright. Yeah, there's apparently somebody who's watching me from the middle there. And, is the phone there on top of the table? That is something that I am yet to find out. I do not know about. Maybe Sadono took the phone over to the other room. Something happened, I don't know what, but something happened. I switched that object off. Change up that object. Should be safe here. Is the phone there? I do not see it, if the phone is there. If it is not there, then it's sort of pointless for me to waste my time here, but yeah, it is what it is. I mean, I do not see any phones there. Maybe the computer? Sure that I
should
shoot this camera out.
Good work, Fisher.
Later? Okay, that was the phone. Okay. Sneak out through the back door traffic. I wonder if this is the back door. Of course, it is not. It leads to the interior of the house. One of those should be the back door. I took the light off for the sake of convenience. I guess the only way we can go is through this door.
Fisher, freeze! Don't make a move. Shetland will take you out of there.
the space sniper, so.
I'm engaging the enemy!
I mean, I suppose going the other way is a brighter idea, I guess. That was a quick reload. Why don't you take these people out? I'm not sure about this section of the game at all. Okay, so I just needed to run through. Different mission, interesting mission, challenging mission, and yeah, I mean, it was unconventional for Pandora Tomorrow style. They gave us a little more freedom with movement and how we approach and solve puzzles. At the same time, there were still the very linear, strict sections of puzzles where there was like one specific solution. It was almost literally like a point-and-click adventure puzzle where, you know. Yeah, just turn off, like for example, in the travel app, you just turn off the main bar and then you make your way through in the middle of the lab. And yeah, it's pretty much just the same thing. Pretty strange if you ask me, but yeah, it's fun. It's fun. I mean, once in a while, if you play Pandora, it's more damn fun. Not. It's just that the level design is not something that I would recommend. But then again, I think I'm beating an old drum right now. So, yeah, singing an old tune. Refinery Kundang, Indonesia. April 12, 2006, 18:15 hours. Mission complete. Grim Sodier traced Sadono's Pandora to one phone call for several relay points before losing it in a shipyard on an island off the eastern coast of Indonesia. So I was basically confusing the shipyard mission with this mission. But, yeah, even that mission is quite fun. This mission was also quite fun. And, yeah, both missions are quite fun, all in all. I suppose the next mission has a little bit of a brutal starting area, if I remember it correctly. And then there's, of course, the shipyard mission where you get into a submarine. But anyway, just to recapitulate what happened thus far. We found Saudi Sadono's location and we just went ahead and planted a bug on his phone as like sort of a, what do you call it, countermeasure against this failsafe of the threat of the smallpox virus, the Pandora Tomorrow code that he says every day just to make sure that the viruses aren't released and that, you know, a measure against his death or capture so that, you know, he can threaten the world with plague in case he does not live to see the day or, well, in case he pretty much just dies. So, yeah, we essentially neutralized that threat. Took a bit of doing, but the phone trace from that sort of reveals that the call ends at a shipyard off the coast of the eastern coast of Indonesia, which is, I think, should be a little far off from Delhi. that is East Timor. But yeah, so that was pretty much it. That's pretty much all this mission was about, infiltrating this entire camp just for this basic piece of intel. And yeah, I mean, that's pretty much what they do. That's pretty much what SAN does, signals intelligence. So yeah, as for today's video, thank you for watching, thank you for sticking around to the end, and thank you for tuning in. When we come back next time, we will be covering an infiltration into the shipyard. Until then, into the shipyard, you know, mentioned here. Until then, take care. Farewell, fellow things.